Welcome back, friends and thoughtful gamers, to our good Jarldom of Upland. Led by us, we want to become Sweden. So how Munzo can lead Sweden, as I've done in reality, until I think the 10th, 11th century, somewhere then. And our legendary Jarlbjörn Ironside of Upland wanted to do so, but now he's under attack. There's some people from Naum de la Filki who want Medelpad. They're attacking, not that successful, but they're kind of annoying. And then we have an inherited war because we took Småland. And now we have a war against, for taking Finnviden, going from Holland. So we have two wars we have to look at, and that we have to win, or otherwise they will haunt us and will make us look weak. So that's what we're gonna do, and what we want is to form Sweden. Let's go. First things would be capturing their armies in a good position. They are fleeing from us. They should. They should. Oh, look. War is coming. Godi Anund of Naum de la Filki is leading here. Wow, with a martial skill of 15, who is good. But our burger is also now good. So that's fine. And we're trying to overtake these guys from Holland. We are catching them as well, with a big advantage for us. A helpful warning. I've received a missive from Jarl Hrane of Westergotland. It claims that Chieftain Dyer, my vassal, has requested support in a plot against me. There's nothing I value more than loyalty, Hrane's letter reads, hence why I share this with you. Aha. A neighboring ruler? And Chieftain Dyer. Insane Blackguard is plotting against us. Is that true? I mean, he likes us, but he's an insane Blackguard, even though he has very, very low intrigue. How about his spouse? She's also very bad at that. We could confront him. Say that he's guilty, or do something else here. Wait, let me see. The Jarl can't be trusted. Protected vassal honor. Liege looking away. Of all but serious transgressions. If he's disloyal. If he's disloyal. What is it with Jarl Hrane? Is he our friend? Not really, right? I mean, he kind of likes us, but other than that, the Jarl can't be trusted. My vassals have my support. Yeah, that insane Blackguard has my support. Of course, we need him in this war. What did we do? Why are we going away from this? Why? Or who is? Oh, the tribe of Sigtuna. We're standing here, right? And they are fleeing. As they should. There's a raider army coming in here. I really don't like that. The raiders of Freysey. Let's run over here. So what can we catch? Oh, we're going over here. We don't want that. We want to take back Finnviden. Instead, let's see what we can do here. So they're going back to their ships, beaten and in trouble. And we're going over there to Medelpad and maybe then to Itri Naumuldar. But only when we have finished this conflict with Finnveden. So first we need to take back Finnveden. And then we'll see what more we can do. Enemy ally joins war. Chieftain Håkon. Chieftess Goli. Chieftain Rønvalde. But into what? Yeah, not the Hollanders, I guess. Maybe these guys. Woo! Really, that's... Ugh. And Ingibjörg has the bubonic plague. Go out of my lands, you crazy people. We won't go there and visit them. The bubonic plague already. We need a way to found Sweden, really. Let's see. We can create titles. Now that is really interesting. We need 250 to get Sweden. We need 250 gold. So that's our next goal. 250 gold. Prisoners! Who's that man? A cowardly lackey. Unknown. Can release him for a favor. He could be a very good steward. We could recruit him even. Okay, prowess, a novice physician. Generous. We could torture him. Execute, ransom. We'll just keep him in there. Negotiate release. Not really. How about Jaros? He's somewhere from the Czech Republic. Why do we have these people here? Chieftain Ulfr of Sweden. Yeah, we need to win that. Oh, we already won that. I think we can release him because he's now our vassal. Maybe he can pay for it. He cannot. Negotiate the release. What will we do? What about... Huh? Spinitif. No, we don't want to... We want it with... With Ulfr. Ah, okay. Now, he would give us some money. We need the money. Normally we'd say, hey, he's a vassal now. He's okay, but we really need the money. And this man, Army of the Aure. I don't even know. We could gain a weak hook. Nah, it's fine. So that's there, that's fine. We're gaining on Naum de la Filke. We're gaining here as well. They're just derping around here, the Hollanders with their 160 men. Some of them pikemen, I guess. Men-at-arms negotiation. Nice. Low maintenance for men-at-arms. Well, look at them. They're losing men here. They're 150. Army of Sigtuna is here. We're getting a lot of prestige, which we'll need in the future, being tribal. But really, if the bubonic plague is just around the corner... We really need Sweden. What's going on there? The first raiders of Borgholm are raiding the chiefdom of Sweed. We cannot tolerate this. What's going on there? Ah, they're coming again. Back then. Now we got Finnveden back. Now let's go to Holland. I mean, to be fair, we could beat them here, but they cannot even do anything, so we'll just take Holland. And drive these people away in their madness. They cannot even do anything. What is that? Dalrane has lost against our steward, Chieftain Ivar. In the conquest of the chiefdom of Skara. Oh, so that is ours as well now. Great. Well done, Ivar. Enemy ally joins war. Chieftess Aslaug replaced Chieftess Gulli. Aha, okay. So she died of the bubonic plague. Now we have Grandma taking over. Well, Grandma, she's 48, but she seems to be the one left to take over. You know things are not going that well when you're ruled by a bubonic plague-ridden two-year-old, but now it's even worse. Oh, look at that. I think we're winning that, aren't we? Nice. That Battle of Sigtuna. They lost a lot. Yeah, the most important thing is they lose more. Ugh, they're bringing the bubonic plague over here. That's the real dangerous thing. Back to Metalpud with you. They're doing absolutely nothing here. As soon as we have taken over Holland, I think we'll hopefully win. These enemy allies joining war are just the people here dying all the time of the bubonic plague. Ooh. We need a disease map for this. A disease map, I tell you. Soon we'll have the fort in Holland, and then we shall not be stopped anymore. Maybe there's a new concubine here for us. No, no, not at all. Absolutely not. Here we go. We can enforce demands. We gain prestige and money. Everything will be fine for us. Here we go. We keep Finn Whedon. And Sjaland has also grown, if you can see that. Pretty big, pretty big. That's the usual contest. Denmark against Sweden. Against not yet Sweden, but we will change that soon. We will change that soon. Now let's go over here. What about this? They're starting to ship over here, or what? Yeah, I believe, though. They are doing that. No, we don't want to pay. We indeed want the Kingdom of Sweden. Let's give us that title. The Jarldom of Småland and the Jarldom of Uppland, and we will create the title of Sweden. We are now a mighty king. Realm succession will be inherited according to our male preference confederate partition law. So, confederate partition. All children inherit equally. Ah. Under confederate partition, your titles will be divided equally between your children. New titles may be created for younger realm heirs. Younger children will be given titles starting with those of the same rank as the primary title. None are available, they will be given lower ranking titles. Your player heir cannot be preemptively granted titles. They do not stand to inherit. Younger children will have titles created for them if enough land is held. And tribal rulers are locked to this succession type. Except we are not locked to this. Because we have some specialty, I think. A Scandinavian elective law. that's here. Based on our culture, we will think on the matter, but not right now. Because election, that removes all this, I have an heir, let's train that heir, let's give that heir that. On the other hand, it might make us more powerful. So we have to ponder that really, really a lot. Now, there's something else. Let's again look at the prisoners. How about the chieftain here? Captain Bohuz. Oh, I don't know. Kettle. Prisoner Kettle. I mean, we'd really like to have him there. Can we kind of recruit him? Negotiate the release? We can recruit him. He will accept. And gain a weak hook? No. Here we go. Kettle's nice. We want to keep him. Jaros, for a favor, we can demand conversion and recruit him. Would that be good? He has 10 prowess, so he's trusting, generous, stubborn, tough soldier, and open terrain expert. Yeah, I think we want him as a champion. Negotiate the release for him. This man, on the other hand, well, he's an aggressive attacker. Let's negotiate. Conversion and recruitment. Then we have this man. Who is a dwarf? we can only demand conversion. Gain a weak hook? I don't know. Yeah, let's just release him. It's okay. So, we're the king of Sweden now, and this is Sweden. We now have a lot of de jure claims, and we can really look more towards the north. And, look at that. Are we at war with this as well? Prandheim. Chieftain Rönnwald of Prandheim. And they have more soldiers now. I don't know if I'm really convinced by that. No choice but to accept your conditions. Farewell, Kettle. Watch your step now. Farewell, Jaros. How about them? Söder coming in. It's a neutral army. We can gain more of this. Let's see. Defensive negotiations. Fellow vassal opinion 15. Independent rude opinion 15. Can propose one alliance without a marriage. Then the ducal conquest. Title creation cost goes down. And adaptive traditions. Foreign affairs effectiveness plus 25%. Wow. But we want to control our vassals first. So let's go for defensive negotiations first. Will help us control the new kingdom very well. So we've got them here. We'll ship over. Oh wait, we can instantly go over here to Prandheim, to Nidaros. That might be a good thing. We have a lot of skirmishers and levies and some champions with us. Through downcast lashes, as my eyes meet Chieftess Halla of Goatlands for what feels like the 20th time tonight, I know I am not imagining things. Even from the other end of the table, her gaze feels as intense as the midday sun. She wants me, and I am terrified. Of her husband, Chieftain Eric, our son? Or of what I might do, I cannot say. Everyone will know. No, my heart remains pure. No. Let's not meddle with our son's wife. That's not a great idea at all. I mean, if it would have been another wife, okay, but not our sons. That's BS. BS. They're going over here? Are they, like, going back shipping something? I don't know. We'll see how that goes. We'll keep everyone mobilized and ready to strike. We stand ready. Upland is under siege. Ah, again. They did it again. They did it again. Save Upland. A low quality commander and 200 archers. Not the best, but you negotiate an alliance with Earl Gudfried of Lothian. Isn't Lothian somewhere here? I forgot. Where's Lothian? Oh, our uncle. Yeah, why not Lothian? With our nephew. That's how it should be. We're a diplomat. And that's not really a power play, but our mother died. Oh no! Well, she was 72. I guess in these times. Well, she was pretty and quick. Wow, everything our wife was would never be. But our wife is intelligent, which means even goes further. Even goes further. Our children, though, are not. But at least they are not dumb, so stop that, I guess. Let's see. Yeah, we're doing well in sieging Praunheim. They're going away. Let's see. Are they moving over? Are they? Yes. The trappings of majesty. I stand above my subjects as a sovereign ruler, unequaled in the realm. Dressing the part with resplendent garments and jewelry would serve as a subtle reminder to everyone that I'm in charge. Now the question is, would we do that? I mean, we're honest and we're impatient. Only the finest ermine and velvet for me. We cannot afford this. Local fashions have symbolic meaning. Look for a tailor for a traditional raiment. Or a boring and unimpressive outfit. I do not need things to legitimize my rule. I mean, that would be maybe something we would try. Local fashions have symbolic meaning. Hey, we've gained that outfit fit for a king. And let's see. The Battle of Östhammer. Oh, nice. We're at an advantage with our low-quality levies. We have the better commander, definitely. And we're hitting it with the archers. Great. Whoa. Casualties are not looking great. But we will win this, no doubt. We captured Freya during the siege of Nidaros. Nice. Pursuing now. Are they coming in? Let's see. Wow, what a disadvantage they have now. Pursuing again. Chieftess Aslaug's courtier Swerker. We've gained so many things, and we can enforce the demands of this war. We get some money and some fame. can disband all armies and be proud of ourselves. And we now have a lot of prestige, which means we should and could and should. Look, we have two very, very many levies. We should definitely increase the size of our bowmen. Once they are full, we will go further, acquire more. We're stressed a little bit. That's something not so good. Loyalty or fear? My vassals owe me their allegiance. Yeah. Eirik and Oho of Finland. Yeah, I'll win their unwavering loyalty. We're a generous liege. We can afford that. Now let's see what we'll do. We can commission an epic. We don't have the money for it. We can go on a pilgrimage. That would be cool. But I think we should lose stress. So let's call for a hunt. We're a novice hunter and brave. So that fits our character definitely. The cost is 67. Wow. Notify us. But sound the horn now. A hunt fit for a king. Battle of Osthammer. Ah, that was kind of good. And that other Battle of Osthammer, that was good. Errand, yeah. Oh, what did he do? My son, Chieftain Eirik, went on ahead of the group chasing a bear. I followed close behind and I find him standing above a commoner. Took an arrow out of the poor man's chest. As soon as he sees me, he hides the arrow behind his back. 'Twas the bear, father, I swear. Soon enough, the rest of the party will catch up and demand an explanation. Oh, we must cover this up. We get a lot of stress if we do that. Too bad the bear got you both. We cannot expose our heir. Oh my goodness me. We must cover this up somehow. But we're not good at that. We're terrible at that. How about that? Diplomacy. We will have to lie. Eirik fought valiantly to save him. I saw it. Everyone believes me. We still gain stress, though. We saved him. He saved our heir. Returning from the wild, the hunt is drawing to an end. We mount our horses to leave the plains behind, as the servants prepare the bear and other game for the journey back. In spite of our difficulties along the way, the hunt went very well. We return home, reinvigorated, and hopefully lose some stress. 71. Oh, our glory is widely known. We have a lot of fame now. We're illustrious. Really, really good. So, let's set our eyes on something else, right? Maybe a raid would be something. But who isn't being raided here? I mean, that looks like a ravaged land. Should we just stabilize Sweden? Or should we grasp for more? Where could more lie? Jämtland. Jarlbjörn of Jämtland. The Zealous Craven. What a combination that is. The One-Legged Holy Warrior and Craven. That is... For the god of running and runs away. Oh, what does that mean? I mean, that would definitely be something. Harald Fairhair of Westfold. Yeah, that's ideal, but Jarl Dag of Upland, a spineless villain. Hmm. how that was the one who wrote us that terrible letter. Could we declare war on him? He has one ally. Jarl Ivar of Bergslagen. Wow. We have two allies that are of no use. We could try to subjugate it, but we really cannot. Why can't we? Ah, because it is only once in a lifetime we can do that. All right. That's fair. I see. I see. Well, then, I mean, the rest of the people, I mean, this is owned by one of our brothers. The rest of our friends. We might take it slower. At least until we have a very sizable army. And we might first look at the court, because we're already seeking some more concubines. Kiello. Lazy, chaste, zealous. Not really a concubine. Swanhild. 26. Gregarious, temperate, cynical. Yeah, I mean, we could recruit her to court. Ingfrid of Dovre, not really. She's such a schemer. That's not what we really want, I think. How's Dovre? I govern. And she's also 34 already. Chitska is a little bit dangerous. We have a new kid here. Swanhild is now a member of our court. She's actually in pretty good health. We can make her a concubine. Here we go. We have more prisoners. Let's see. Freya. Trende. We have Rollaug Trende. We have Hallad Trende and Tore Trende. Yeah, let's take it step by step. Maybe we'll improve our lands now. That seems like a good idea. The chiefdom of in the war for the chiefdom of Gwent. Oh, the lordship of Gwent. Somehow Gwent sounds familiar. They're playing a lot of cards there, I guess. Ransom. Hallad Trende is dear to me. Yeah. Here we go. Give us more money. More prisoners. Tore. Content villain. Pensive, sadistic, fickle, and generous. Yeah, don't you want him? What about Rollaug? An honorable altruist, is curious, trusting, and a bastard. He's got no claims. We could maybe keep him, I don't know. Or we can gain money. Probably the better choice. How about our military and our champions? They're doing fine. We can create new men-at-arms. And we should do that too. So we definitely wanted pikemen, I think. Mountains, hills. That's something we could go armored footmen. They're very strong, just very, very strong. And light horsemen. Now it seems like it's more mountainy what we will next go for. So I think some pikemen won't be bad. actually get this to size 2. So we have a nice combination of things. 6 issues. We can create more duchies. That's definitely something good. For our sons, at least. The Duchy of Visby. But we need money for that. And money is much better spent in buildings for now. So let's see. We definitely want to improve our capital. And I think we want to build gathering halls, because they also give us prestige. Control and prestige. Markets would also be great. Palisades, definitely great. But gathering halls, that's so classic. And it also gives us prestige. And prestige makes us roll. It really makes us roll. Let's construct that. The traditional Viking longhouse. That's just something we want. Back to Sweden, my friends. And I made a little pause. Let's see what we can do. I still think we want to go on a pilgrimage, but it's too expensive for us now. So there has to be something we should do. And that's something, it could be a war. It could also be just raiding, you know? Because we're mostly surrounded by friends. We have kind of stabilized. Yeah, maybe the man of Upland isn't the greatest friend. We'll see about that. We would look at definitely Finland to raid. Maybe Kurland. Maybe just these coasts. Lübeck comes to mind. Usually a very rich land here. Jylland, maybe not so much. Still Norse. Rather the Christian and Eastern religions. So definitely. Something like that. Once the pikemen are filled up, we'll do that. And when speaking of it, we should maybe just go for that completely. Just go all in with that. And then we can raid. Maybe even with 2 different troops. I know it's really low prestige, but we'll get there. Oh, look at that. Additional taxes. 100. Your steward's excellent stewardship skill led to this windfall. Wow. 100 extra. Are you kidding me? Yeah, we're building something. And we need prestige for that. And we're building that thing. A longhouse. But it has 5 years left building. So you cannot just build everything at once. Even though it's a little bit less expensive than in the predecessor games. You also need prestige. We need prestige and money. And so raiding seems to be a good thing. On the other hand, yeah, we'll have a look around, you know. We could also try really for Finland. Because they're really not that strong here. Let's have a look at that land. It's taiga. It's more taiga and more taiga and more taiga. So it's really bad land. Hard to tell. Livonia. Yeah. It's plains. It's much better land. Our neighbor has won against the petty kingdom, Earth of Cornwall. Harald Fairhair of Westfold has won there. Okay. And he's also lost something. We'll have a look. I mean, look at that now. Now we're really full. I mean, the levies are still counting up. We have 11 champions. That's all fine. And dandy. I think we should start raiding a bit. There's something going on here. With the army of Westeros. Are they taking our grandson with them? That would be terrible. He's a brilliant strategist. We really want him to be one day be a ruler of our dynasty. A zealot too. Let's raise all his raiders for now. I just think that's gonna be okay. Let's see. And we have a new perk. Let's see. You could go for embassies. Each alliance grants one diplomacy. Here we have two alliances. That's not too bad. Let's just unlock this. The Raiders of Sigtuna. There's nothing here, of course. There's 15 here. Let's see about, like, better things. Zero here. Nothing. 15. Zero. Zero. Wow, that's really bad. Can we raid anywhere? I mean, what in the name of... Maybe the Christians in England? No. Absolutely not. There's nothing to be had, like, everywhere. It isn't a good idea. Let's disband the army. It doesn't make sense. We have to find a war. We have to find something that we can acquire. And of course, neighbors come to mind. Let's look at what having Sweden means. The Kingdom of Sweden, among other things, has the Duchy of Norrland. Let's see about that. We could even create that. We have 2 out of 2 counties for this thing. The Duchy of Visby, the Duchy of Westergötland. That's here. We cannot create that title because... Yeah. Someone else has that county here, so... That's inside our realm. De jure duchies. It's Bergslagen, Småland. We have Bergslagen. We have Småland fully. Definitely. Uppland we have. And Östergötland. Where's Östergötland? We have Västergötland here. And Östergötland's here. We also have that. So there's not that much left to do. I mean, we could create the Duchy of Visby just for the sake of it. So our son would be a duke. That would maybe not be bad. But it costs a lot. Nah, it's not good. So we have to look for other things. Now, these are our friends. They are very weak friends, but still. That's the Hed dynasty in Uppland. Yeah, that man is not that much our friend. He has insulted us. That doesn't belong to Sweden, really, though. Finland would be the next step, right? Westfold. Westfold would be something as well. From House Yngling. I mean, that's pretty easy. Vastly inferior. They're inferior. These guys are inferior, but strong. Finland is just terrible. Terrible to us. It's probably good to take this before Sjellon gets it. We should ask if someone wants to become our vassal. No. We could ask Jarl Dag. And then Jarl Björn is at war. Roald, not really. That man is at war. That one will not accept. Not accept. Yeah, we need a border. Sjelland, that's our brother, and he will not become our vassal, of course. Now let's see. Jarl Dag of Uppland, a spineless villain who really, really hates us. He wants a seat on the council. How old is he? He's 30. He's a craven, he's callous and deceitful. Excellent. So, if we give him that seat on the council, we already have a very good spy master, Chieftain Solvi. This man, he could become our chancellor. Oh, the chieftain of Neerik has Chieftain Gudmund. Yeah, I mean, but we have to replace the chieftains with Jarls, so that's true. So let's first see what kind of, if we can have someone else here. Because really, let's see, the power. Power. How is the power? The power is terrible with these people. Vagn of Finnweden is relatively good. Ulfr of Swede is at least versed in diplomacy. Let's have him here. It's to be better. And then our spymaster. We have to appoint Jarl Dag. It's just much... He's even better. And Sylvie is just... Yeah, he's just only a chieftain. Here's our Rikskodi. Yeah, we cannot really fire her. You know, she's our concubine. And she has some of our children, has born at least one of our children. Swanhild, we can find one more concubine. But really, we cannot. Let's look at the court, at our guests. There's a woman named Katarina. She's 34. She's got some stewardship. She's calm, impatient, stubborn, and a thrifty clerk. Really, why not invite her? Recruit her to court. And make her a concubine. Another concubine. Here we go. That will be indeed prestigious. And so now let's see. We have acquired that. Chieftain Ulfr of Gaudelafilki could be the next Vestfold. Yeah, he cannot join because he's at war. We could offer him to join the war. So what we'll do now, we have a couple of things. Now Jarl Dag has joined us of Uppland. So that's a new realm in here. And we will have to look if we can maybe convince others to join us as well. And if that's not the case, we might declare war, for example, on him. I can conquer the duchy even. Or the county. It doesn't really matter. And then we can get one more holding. That would be also nice. So, we'll see what happens. We'll just let it run for a bit and see how everyone reacts. And then see at the beginning of the next month how people react. We can offer vassalage and he will accept. And of course, being a diplomat, we're rather doing it like that. It's absolutely clear. That guy is at war. He's also at war. Oh, let's wait for this. He wants to accept. Excellent. Let's see about Jämtland. He's also at war. Everyone's at war. I mean, it's really crazy. He's also at war. That guy was at war, right? Nah, he will not accept, and he is at war. Why? Base reluctance, not the jury or vessel. So it's a little bit tough. So Sjælland is another thing because we have a king there. Or do we have a king? No, we have a Jarl. We have a Jarl Sigurd. And he will not accept, but it's close actually. It's quite close. The opinion of us could be better, and if it goes high, you never know. Finland? They will not accept because of faith, so that's pointless to wait for something like this. We could really wait for the wars to end here. Other than that, yeah, he would become our vassal. So I think the main thing to do now is probably to just go on a pilgrimage. So we can wait a bit, do something good. Hosting a feast, though, is probably also something good, right? Because we have a lot of stress, we can reduce the stress. Increases our vassal's opinion of us, and that's probably even better to do that before the pilgrimage. So we'll send the invitations. A cheery gathering. The guests are gathered in the great hall. Lords and ladies, well, chieftains, from the near and far reaches of the realm. The mood is bright and the spirits are high as the feast begins. And now, the witness. As I stumble outside to relieve myself, I hear shouting around the corner. As I turn, I see my daughter, Queen Ingrid. Ah, she's come as well. Sneer as she sinks her blade into the face of the covering Jarl Dag. What? Our... What? Is he dead now? She sinks her blade into the face of the covering Jarl Dag. If a sound I made must have been enough for Ingrid to... turns towards me, surprise on her face. What have you done? You exposed. No, she's our daughter. I mean, okay, he's... Wow. Now, what have you done, daughter? Oh, goodness me. We need a new spymaster again. Chieftain Sölvi. Now let's look at rank again. Or at power, rather. The Jarl of Bergslagen is a... Chieftain Gudmund of Nerik. Swain of Öland. No, it's gotta be Sölvi again. Welcome back. And we'll sway him a bit. We need to sway. We need to sway. Wow. What a feast, eh? Way to reduce stress. Goodness me. Oh. Oh my God. So, the right woman for the job. My dear wife, Ilyana, has been working hard to ensure that everything about the feast goes smoothly. The food arrives on time, the guests are all seated in the right place, and everyone seems content. With Ilyana beside me at the great table, everything is ready. I squeeze her hand and smile at her before rising to announce the start of the celebrations. What would I have done without her? Look at that. Courtiers and guests and the direct vassals enjoy it, really, and we lose even more stress now. So great. So great. Dark. And he was so good at intrigue, but our daughter was just more bold. As my guests depart, with everyone headed for their respective homes, I'm proud to say the feast was a success. Everyone ate a lot and, yeah, I think we were celebrating like our 50th birthday with that feast. My wife Ilyana to thank much for this success, and I feel nothing but gratitude as she sees the last guests off. We gain prestige, and every guest gains 20 opinion of us. Wow, that's truly powerful. And now we can definitely go on a pilgrimage. Let's prepare for the journey, eh? Time for me to set out on my journey to one of the holy places. But which one? Sigtuna. Is it a temple? Roskilde, Paderborn? Now, we don't want to go to foreign lands. We want to visit, really, Sigtuna. Here we go. Our own temple. Temple of Uppsala. Departure. I prepare for my journey. I know that I will travel safely under the protection of the gods. Though I will not be gone for long, I pray for the well-being of the realm in my absence. It's time to depart. Our tried and true spymaster is back and everything seems to be okay. We will check from time to time if we can offer vassalage. No. Not so much, at least not now. Maybe later. Love thy neighbor. Among my fellow pilgrims, there's a woman who preaches compassion and fellowship until she reaches the topic of heathens. One evening around the campfire, she loudly declares them to be abominable monsters in the eyes of the gods, deviants and child murderers all. Most people avert their eyes when she looks at them. Tonight I was not quick enough. Do you not agree, O king? I could say they are not all bad. Or we could say we agree. And what do we see? I mean, definitely from our story, a Christian king murdered our father. And I think that's still very present, because it's not that far away. So we agree. I agree, and I would not trust anyone who came to their defense. Disdain for heathens. A Norse ruler and a Satru ruler. We must make Sweden great. The arrival. I'm finally here, body and soul, at the great temple of Sigtuna. The Hofgodi offers me blessings. I reflect on everything that had to happen for the gods to bring me here, this moment in time. I've walked the holy path in the footsteps of my forebears. Known for the dedication. Let's see. Close family opinion plus 10. All right. Very nice. So we have that going. Let's see. I mean, they would certainly join. How about them? They would probably not join. He's not de jure our vassal. The return. My journey has been a long one, but I've finally come home again. But much remains the same. Something has changed in how the Godar and Hofgodar treat me. I've undergone the journey of a holy man, and they insist it has changed something about me. Whether I can see it myself or not, it's good to be home. Good to be home. How about him? Oh, we can ask him to be our vassal. Jarl Björn, let's offer him the vassalage as well. Jämtland joins Sweden. My liege. And it's only plus 12, so how about we sway him now instead? I think that's maybe even better. Let's see, how's the spy master? It's pretty good now. Yeah, let's start that scheme. Let's sway Jarl Björn. And let's see, we have Upland. Oh, Jarl Anders Darkson. He's only 5 years old. The compassionate gambler. Oh, goodness me. All right. All right. Conquest of the chiefdom of Jakamaka. Jämtland. Is that Jämtland what we've won now? Or whatever that was now, right? Let's see. They're still at war. He will just not accept. Jarl Hrothgar. Why? Base reluctance. Not de jure or vassal. I mean, that's understandable, partly. How about Naum whatever? Chieftess Aslaug. She will accept. Sweden for the win. Excellent, Chieftess Aslaug. How about Aritje? It's a high chiefdom, though. That means it's a kingdom, basically. Of a different faith. It begins. There's Submi faith. Okay, all right. And we have Bodin here. But they're a Satru. Yeah, they are. May the power of Sweden rise, my friends. The vassals are there. How's it going now? We will check everywhere all the time. How about this guy is that poor little boy is at war as well. What is that? Lellemurg. He will not accept as well. But really, why? Why exactly will this guy not join? What's the problem here? It's the base reluctance. True ruler, opinion of us is pretty good, so we can propose an alliance. Yeah. Now, is that? That's an Asatru. Ruler. Something great is coming. Sweden. Look, the man with the mask is back. Excellent, excellent. Let's see. What's the faith? Yeah, it's... Ooh, look at that. There's some insular faith. Insular Christianity, though. There's some faith here. Satru of the Liege, but only. So we'll have to see. We'll have to see how that can be stopped, kind of. Norway. Yeah. Norway has a problem. Norwell will hopefully not be founded, but it may be founded by one of our heirs, really. So, difference in military strength. Yeah, Rodgar. Minus seven. Seven, it's only seven that is missing. Maybe we should sway this man. Maybe we should. Yeah, we'll sway this man. It might be that we can convince him. My dear uncle, I call on you to honor our alliance and join me in the Lothian conquest of the Mormordon of Linlithgowshire. Our opponent would be Mormer Felbe MacComgall of Linlithgowshire. I think I'm in Blackadder now. Mormordom of... Where's that? It's somewhere here. Whatever. That's our enemy. Christian enemy. Yeah, we'll accept, of course. For glory. Now, let's see. Where do we have to attack? Where do we have to go, even? Where's our enemy? Is it Alba? It's Alba, it seems. Yeah, it's Corsantin. Okay, we could go over and sail to Corsantin. We can raise all the armies. We have a ton of armies, as I see now. 5,000. Chieftain Björn has also joined. And we can go over here. Let's see about our military. We have enough champions. I think we should leave half of the army here. Let's split that in half. And the army of Sigtuna will go and travel. Over to Alba. Because other than that, I don't see where the conflict is, right? Conflict is somewhere around here. So we'll have to travel over there. And we will experience this war in the next episode. Thank you for watching and happy gaming to you. Have a great time until next time and happy gaming. And we travel to the British Isles. For glory and for the Norse faith. See you soon. Happy gaming.